Well, we're getting married in September.
Oh, you're not married yet?
No, we're getting married in September. Yeah. And we...
You're a nice couple.
Thank you.
It's clear.
Thank you. We wanted to know what's the best thing...
I've tailored this for you, haven't I?
Yes, I've been listening to you all these years. So.
What's the best thing that we could do to not repeat what our parents have done?
Listen to me.
You know, and also raising our children.
Am I giving you some clues?
Yes, you are.
Yeah. This is sort of like, I hear it, let me say it another way. So when you have sex, if you use the woman as an object, as a salvation object, which means to be complete, you become a complete ass. See? And that's what makes men weak for love or bullies for love. Either one is unacceptable. Correct? Because if the man is weak for love, you have contempt for him. See that? So you see, I hope that all these words are not confusing. That carefreeness is a freedom from people, places, things, and even your new car. That is, that you have no bondage, but you are bonded. It means you have a relationship that is, that you've the God in you has recognized the authority of the God in your husband, and you're pleased that he is the one with the strength that will point things out to you when you're out of order, and it is even though it's smarts, you take the correction. And if he's wrong, you won't hate him. See that? Because he's going through periods too. See? And if you take your place of not resenting him when he's out of order, because he can't always be perfect. The whole idea is becoming perfect. So therefore, your gentle, your forgiveness, your patience with his foolishness, and not frustration, will help him see himself. You don't have to preach to him. You don't preach to men. See that?